Hello, viewers. I warmly welcome you to Great Vikvilan Academy virtual class. I am your facilitator for integrated science. In our lesson today, we shall look at water. Now, curriculum, water. We shall look at water. Now, let us look at our objectives for today's lesson. Let me repeat and let me remind you that my name is James Makion. As I told you earlier on, I am your facilitator for integrated science for upper primary. And we are looking at water. And so, let us see our objectives or what the lesson shall cover by the end of this lesson. I hope you are with me. Join me. By the end of this lesson, people should be able to identify five human activities that make water unsafe. Objective two. By the end of today's lesson, pupils should be able to study five ways of conserving water. By the end of today's lesson, pupils should be able to mention three methods of making water safe or clean for human use. Now, water is one of the important resources that supports animal and plant life on Earth. This indicates or mean that without water, human being cannot live. Water is life. Water is essential to man and plant life. When we talk about basic necessities in life, the basic necessities in life. Water is also one of the three basics, which are water, air, and food. Water is very important to the life of plants and animals. So in our lives on Earth, there's no way we can eliminate water in our activities or whatever we do. And so we said man uses water to cook, bath, and we drink with water. Because of all these activities, it tells us that water is very important to the life of man and to that of plants. Plants also uses water through the soil and to the stems and enable the plant to grow or survive. Without water, man and plant cannot live well. This indicates that water is very essential to both plants and animal. Because water is very important to the life of both man and plants or animals. Water should be very clean. Water should be safe. Water should not contain any impurities so that man can survive and man can live well. Because water is very important, very necessary to the life of man. There are some activities or human activities that make water unsafe for use. There are human activities that make water unsafe or polluted. The diagram below, as you can see, shows a sewage thrown into water bodies, making it unsafe for human consumption. What I'm talking now is human activities. Do not forget that in my lesson, my objectives, I made mention that some human activities that make water unsafe. So here we are talking about some of the human activities that make water unsafe for both plants and animal. I believe you are still following. So in your diagram, or the diagram below shows that sewage pipes are connected from homes or houses or from industries containing sewage, and it's being connected to water bodies. This sewage being connected to the water bodies make the water unfriendly or unsafe for human, for both human and animal consumption. In this case, on this way, we say that the water is polluted or water pollution. So there are a lot of human activities that make water unsafe for both man and animal. Unsafe water contains germs and poisonous substances and sometimes smell. Let me take that again. Unsafe water contains germs and poisonous substances and sometimes smell. This means that water contains impurities, which is unsafe for both man, animal, and plant use. So there is a diagram below what below the explanation I have given to you, which shows that the water contains impurity. The water contains impurities. A lot of substances are found in the water and making the water unsafe or unfriendly for both human, plant, and animal consumption. So here, one may ask that when we talk about water pollution or unsafe water or water that contains impurities, then what are we talking about? What are we talking about? When we say water pollution, what we mean is that water pollution is a situation in which water is contaminated. Water pollution, I take that again. Water pollution is a situation in which water is contaminated. Now let's look at the next definition to water pollution. Water pollution is also the contamination of water bodies, usually as a result of human activity. So when we say water pollution, we mean that a certain substance has been added to what was not previously. When we say something has been contaminated, it means that the thing is clean from impurities or from any other substances. But when a substance is added which are harmful to the life of human activity, then we may say that that particular substance is contaminated or polluted. And so when we say water pollution, then we are saying that it's also the contamination of water bodies, usually as a result of what? Human activity. One may say that, how do one identify water that is being polluted? This is some of the questions maybe one may ask. Water is a substance that should not be contained with any substance. So in that way, we can say that water is colorless, odorless, and tasteless. If one wants to define water in appropriate manner or appropriate way, we say that water is colorless, odorless, and tasteless. This particular definition I have given to you is also properties of water or a characteristic of water, explaining how water is. So this means pure and clean water has no color. When we are talking about pure water and clean water, it means that water or pure water has no color. It doesn't have any color. So if someone asks you, what color is water? Maybe one may find it difficult or may be in a position of saying that water is white, but I have to be sincere to you that water has no color. Water is neither white nor any other color you may suggest. Water is colorless. Water is colorless, meaning that water has no color. So when a substance is being added, or a particular color is being added, or dropped, or mixed up with water, then we are saying that that particular water is not clean or pure. It means that it has been contaminated. Something has been added to the water. Now we are saying that water is odorless. Why do we say water is odorless? Water has no smell or scent. When you take in water, it doesn't have any smell or scent. So whenever you are having water that smells or has a scent in the water, that we are seeing that that particular water has been or have been contaminated. So in our definition, you should be very observant to explain what water is. Water should be colorless, it should be odorless, and it should be tasteless. The last one is tasteless. What is the meaning of tasteless? When we talk about tasteless, that we mean that water has no taste. It is not sweet nor bitter. One cannot take water and tell me that this water is very sweet or this water is very bitter. When you take in water and you get to find out that the water is bitter or sweet, then you are defining water as polluted or something else has been what added to water, changing the properties or how the water behave or what how the water is. I'm sure you are following as we are still treating water. Catch up. Hello, are you still with me? We are still talking about water. So what I want you to understand is that water has no color, has no odor, and has no taste. It doesn't have any color, it doesn't have any odor, it doesn't have any taste. So water is clean, or should be clean, and should be pure. This should be the property of water. Now, since water is clean and pure, keeping its identity, there are some activities, like I mentioned earlier on, that make water unsafe or unfriendly for human use. Some human activities that make water unsuitable for human use. In this way, we can also say that causes of water pollution. If human activity can cause water to be contaminated, then we can also say that what causes water to what? To be polluted. I'm sure you understand what I'm saying. If I have to explain for you to get understand better, all what I'm trying to say here is that water is clean and pure, but that there are some human activities that make water unfriendly or unsuitable for both human, plant, and animals. So we want to see what causes water pollution. And most of the causes are being done or being taken place by human. So in our diagram, we can see a woman washing in a river body. A woman has a lot of clothes and she is at the bank of the river, dropping her clothes and washing in the river. What the woman is doing is making the water unfriendly or unsafe for human use. For this reason, we are saying that the water is contaminated because substances in the clothes is getting the water to be polluted or contaminated. Now to my right, there is also houses with hose or pipe connected to the river body or water body. And we can see with the pipe, there is a sewage. There's a sewage from the pipe dropping inside the water body. And you can see, look at the color of the water. And look at the sewage. You can see that the water is contaminated. Something that is quite different from the originality of the water is being dropped in the water. When I believe when we talk about sewage, you understand sewage. Sewage are harmful substances from our ends. Now, when it's being dropped into the water, we are saying that the water is contaminated. Or if you want to make it clear, to mention it, when we defecate or defecation from our homes, when we drop them, or when we connect such fuses or waste substances coming from our end to river bodies, we are saying that you have dropped sewage or you have damaged sewage into the river bodies. And when such things are being done, it makes the water contaminated or polluted or not making it pure for the sake of both man and plants. It is not only that, it's not only washing and dropping sewages into the water, making water unsafe for use. There are a lot of activities that man go through to make water unsafe for human use. Some of these are when you take animals into river bodies to drink, making the water unsafe. Like we saw in the diagram, when we also wash in the river bodies, making the water unsafe. When we use chemicals to catch fishes in our river bodies, we are also putting poisonous substances into the water. Now let's look at ways of preventing or minimizing or controlling water pollution. Now we're talking about ways or activities of man making water unsafe. Then we should address how to prevent or minimize, or for that matter, we can say how to control water pollution or ways of making water safe for human use. Now let's look at the first one, by avoid dumping into water bodies. Having your rubbish at home, you take them to the river bodies and leave them there, or a gutter. When it rains, you carry them into the river bodies by not dumping into water bodies. 2, practice planting of trees or vegetation and grass. We have to do well by planting trees in our environment. When we do that, we are trying to conserve our water bodies. Now, reduce the use of herbicide. Like I told you, we are fond of using herbicide or chemicals on our lands or in our river bodies or water bodies, making our water unsafe or harmful. So, way of preventing it, or ways of preventing or minimizing or controlling water pollution, is that we have to reduce, if not at all, we have to reduce the use of herbicides, pesticides, and fertilizer on our river bodies or around the river or water bodies. Then again, we have to abstain from flushing pills drop down the drain. I take that again. We have to abstain from flushing pills drag down the drain. This simply can be explained that those of us who don't have a well-created storage facility for our waste, especially our toilets, we have to stop or abstain from such behavior by connecting our pipes into the river bodies. Okay, all these things, when it gets into the river, it makes our water in the river bodies unsafe for human use. But if we are able to cater for all these things, it means that we are trying to minimize or preventing or controlling how to make water polluted, or in another matter, prevention of pollution. Now, in our objectives, we made mention of human activities that make water unsafe for use. Now we are looking at the next one we have in the line is ways of conserving water in our homes, in the schools, and in the community. Before then, we should know what water conservation means. When one say conservation, what does it mean? We don't know what conservation means. How will we be able to explain what water conservation is? My dear friend, my students, my peoples, let's look or read the meaning of conservation. Conservation is a way one use or adopt to avoid wastage. In other words, opposite of conservation is wastage. If you are not conserving water, then you are wasting it. If you are not conserving electricity, then you are wasting it. So opposite of conserve is waste. If you are conserving it, it means that you are not wasting that particular item. Good. I'm sure you are still with me. Water conservation. Now let's take the meaning of water conservation. What it means. Water conservation is a way of ensuring that water is not wasted. So I told you earlier on that the opposite of conservation is wasted or waste. So water conservation is a way of ensuring that water is not wasted. So how can we conserve water in our homes, in our schools, and in the community? Now let's look at home. How can I, or you and I, I'm sure we are all making use of water, like I told you. One cannot go away or go buy water. Water is very, very, very important. It's one of basic necessities. So in every activity or in our homes, whatever we do, we make use of water. So how do we conserve it? How do we make sure that we don't waste water? Okay, let's learn some, my beloved. You are with me. Number one, wash all dirty clothes in box. I take that again. Wash all dirty clothes in box. This means that do not wash your clothes one after the other. You wash one clothes, maybe the next day you wash one clothes. The next day you take your handkerchief, you wash another clothes. No, you have to bring all your clothes that are dirty and wash them at a go. When we are doing that, it means that we are conserving water. We are not wasting water. If you have to take one cloth or one dress and wash and leave the other for another day, it means that we are wasting a lot of water. This makes water scarce, very, very scarce in our community. Now let's look at the second one. Fetch the right quantity of water when in use. I will take that again. Fetch the right quantity of water when not in use. This means that you are not to fetch too much water when you don't need it. For instance, you have to brush your teeth. You fetch 3 cups of water. Meanwhile, you need only one, or you needed only 1 cup of water. Now the rest, what are you going to do with the rest? You can't do anything with it unless you pour the water away. This means that whatever we are doing, before we fetch water, we should anticipate or measure the right quantity of water we need for the right purpose. I'm sure you're also joining us. And the next one is, don't use tap water to wash vehicles. Tap water are very expensive. Tap water are being treated or is being treated. And we invest a lot of resources to make the water clean. That's why it's being called tap water. So if you have to use tap water to wash vehicles, irrespective of the money you have to purchase it, you are still wasting it, because there are so many people or many people elsewhere who need it, but maybe because of shortage, they can't have it. And so not because we have the money or the resource to buy the water, but we have to save water for others also to get water to use. So we are not to use tap water to wash our vehicles, but rather we can get other water that are not clean or pure as tap water. Then again, we have to repair broken pipes that leak. Many of us that we have pipes in our homes, when it's getting leakage or leak, we don't bear much concern about it. What we have been doing is that we just put a bucket under it so that when it is leaking, it may fall in the bucket And it's wrong. You know that when it's full, you throw it away. What else? What if you go to bed? It means that all these kind of water dropping into the bucket or leaking will go waste, irrespective of what the money you have. But causing it very scarce for someone somewhere to get water. So we are to repair broken pipes that leak. Then again, close tap water when not in use. You don't have to open your tap water when you are not using it. It is very, very important to use it. Now, how to conserve water at school? We've done at home. Now let's look at school. In schools, we have to fetch the right quantity of water needed as we need in the school, in our at home. We are to fetch the right quantity of water we needed. We are not to fetch too much water when we don't need it. Like I told you earlier on, you may have money, all right, but as you are wasting the water, someone elsewhere will not get the water to use, making it scarce or scarce for the water to, for the person to get the tap water to use, because tap water is always treated. Number two, we are still talking about how to conserve water at school. So in a school, don't use tap water to scrub urine and the floor. When we are to scrub or the urine or the floor, we are not to use tap water. But I told you earlier on, tap water is very, very expensive and all of us are using it. And so if you are wasting it at a point in time, making it scarce for someone else somewhere, we are not to use, we are not to use tap water to scrub our urinals and the floor. The last one we want to talk about is closed tap when not in use. It also happens in our homes. We are not to just leave our tap waters or tap water on when it is flowing unnecessarily. We are to close them or close it when we are not in use. Now, how do we conserve water in the community? It is very, very important. We talk about it at home, in our schools. Now, in the community we live, how do we conserve it? I believe you understand conservation, so you should continue to be with me. Number one, report any broken pipe to the water authorities for repair. Assuming you are working and you see a tap or a pipe of water and it is leaking or broken somewhere and the water is flowing, what are we to do as students? What are we to do as peoples? As a citizen or good citizen, what we are to do is that we are to report where the pipe was broken to authorities. It may be water company limited people or those who are in charge for water, okay, to repair it so that we can have more and more to use it. Then we have to desist from practice of illegal connection. I read that one again. Desist from the practice of illegal connection. We are to change our mind perception from those who have been connected to the pipe without the notice of authorities. That is very bad. Whenever we are to use pipe, let's consult those who are aware of so that we connected, so that the money we pay, some will be used for development in our communities. Then stop using chemicals to catch fishes. Like I told you earlier on, there are some people, they use chemicals to catch fishes. And as soon as you catch the fishes, the fish itself is polluted. Then the water is also polluted. When these things are being taken into our body, we may fall sick and sometimes we may also die. So it's very necessary we stop using chemicals to catch fishes. Again, encourage afforestation. What did I say? I say encourage afforestation. What does it mean? When we say afforestation, all that we are saying is that we should be encouraged to plant trees in our communities. We should encourage to plant trees in our communities. And this will bring in what you call transpiration, okay, in our community. It also safeguard the water or rivers or lakes in our communities, and to make water safe for use. How to make water safe for use? We get water from sea, lakes, ponds, rivers, streams, lagoons, and wells. Because we get water from these areas, they contain impurities and harmful substances. And so we have to purify water. We have to purify water. When we say water purification, we mean a way of making water clean and safe for use by removing germs, dirty, and harmful substances from water. Now to come your way next time, I say bye-bye. In our objectives, the next time we meet again, we shall look at how harmful or dirty water can be treated, or method of treating dirty water. So come your way the next time. I say bye-bye for now.